have a confession to make. Next Generation's my favorite Star Trek series. I actually think that they found a really nice balance between what was comprehensible to an audience back then and something which was just a little bit further ahead.
This is Steve Perlman, man who dreams that one day we will all live in perfect harmony with computers, just like on board the Enterprise. For the last 20 years, Steve has been at the forefront of computer technology in Silicon Valley, California. His success all started back in the late 80s, when he was a principal scientist at Apple Computers, wondering what to do to make computers do stuff. And then one night, he swept away his hair and watched, you guessed it, The Next Generation.
These guys were dreaming of stuff that wasn't obvious and showing how it could be used. Now, they didn't know how to make a computer do this and how to figure out all the logistics of it, of course. I mean, that's our job.
Now, Steve was about to be inspired when something Star Trek invented caught his eye.
Back then, Data was listening to many copies of music simultaneously played for the speakers.
Mozart's Jupiter Symphony in C major, Molto Vivace, and La Donna e Mobile.
The idea that he could call up any music he wanted on the computer in the Enterprise was a novel idea.
Computer, eliminate program 2.
Now, the music Data was listening to was effectively gazillions of megabytes of information, and yet was able to be accessed at the touch of a button. Seems simple to us now, but back then there was a slight problem. It was impossible.
I remember in 1987, we were about to introduce the Macintosh 2, and it was really the first personal computer that had stereo output. It sounds so trivial now, but it took an entire disc of the largest disc made just to play one single in stereo. And it took a state-of-the-art computer the day it was released in 1987.
There was a bit of a problem. So what did Steve do about it? Simple. Inspired by Star Trek, he helped develop a kind of software which allowed everyone to be as irritating and as noisy as Data, store up all their favorite tunes on their computers, and then access them anytime. That software would, within a few years, become a part of nearly every single home computer in the world. That software is called QuickTime, a multimedia miracle that allows computers to digitally compress, store, and play all kinds of movie and audio files. Steve's software would pave the way for the invention of a few small toys that few people really thought would take off. First, the MP3, and then a revolutionary music player that would transform the fortunes of Apple and be bought by 30 million people in just 4 years. Something called the iPod.
Am I talking too loud? Are we okay?
Steve's various inventions have so far earned him many millions of dollars, so you'd think after all that, you'd think he would be taking it easy. Or maybe not. You see, there's still one piece of Star Trek technology that Steve has a burning desire to make real.
In the 1980s, we were very excited about creating ubiquitous computing, getting audio on computers, getting video playing with QuickTime. But meanwhile, we were watching Star Trek Next Generation, and we were seeing something much more interesting than that called the holodeck.
The holodeck was a great big empty area of the ship, which during your day off, you could download any scenario you fancied from the ship's computer and become part of it.
The vial was placed in his hand after he died.
Why don't you come on in and take a look at my holodeck?
Today, Steve is convinced that he can make the holodeck a reality.
I'm going to regret this.
And that's why he's developing a sophisticated motion capture system that feeds information from retroflective beads positioned on a subject's body into a computer that can then recreate a perfect 3D image of it in some imaginary world. One day, we will all entertain ourselves like this, according to Steve. But you know, Steve wasn't the only one in Silicon Valley inspired to get out there and spread the word of Star Trek by changing the world. They were all at it, including this guy, Rob Haitani. He went out and designed the first ever Palm Pilot. Whatever that is.
Star Trek captures in a lot of ways the spirit of Silicon Valley, not just from the terms of technology. It's about, people feel very passionate about changing the world, and people really think they're doing things that are making people's lives better.
And I bet you all thought the IT industry was just about making money.
They also captured the entrepreneurial spirit of just getting a great group of people together and get on a ship and go.